Hi, and welcome back to my stories on how I started a food business. The topic for this episode is growing the business. You've started the business, you've started, running it for a while now. It's now time to enlarge your business, to make it big. The first generation business owners usually find this hard to do. Because I remember when we started out, one man band, I have to do everything. I was the cleaner, I was the cook, I was the bookkeeper, I was everything. So it was difficult to actually do what people recommend, which is to work not in your business, but on your business. So I was like an employee. So all my time was being taken up by mundane activities in the business. So technically, I was working in a rut. That went on for months, in fact years, before we were able to now free some time, and I was able to now come out of the business and started working to grow the business. So I will say to you, if you are just starting out, take heart, don't worry too much about growing your business when you first set out. Just first of all, worry like every other human, worry about your survival. So once you stabilize the business and money is beginning to come in, try as much as possible to now free up some time to work upon your business. The first aspect that you need to pay attention to in growing your business is product development. Try and have a look at what you have in the marketplace, what are the new trends that are coming in, and then develop new products. If you are unable to develop new products, you can innovate, you can develop your existing product, maybe change the packaging or buy new machineries to make the production faster, to reduce cost. Just try as much as possible to make sure that you are always doing things to make your business better. For instance, you have the Six Sigma system introduced by Motorola. They use this system in big businesses to eliminate waste, to make sure that they remove defects from their business and also generally improve the process of the business. They have this 5S, you find out what is not necessary in your business, keep your business in order, remove things that are not necessary, get rid of cluster, keep the place clean, standardize your system and make sure you monitor the system. In doing this, you are able to keep a clean, productive business. The other area also is quality. You can work upon the quality of your business. If you have good quality products, customers will know you, and consistently, if this is what you keep putting out there in the marketplace, I know of people saying to me that if they eat my jollof rice in any wedding, in any party, they can tell that this food was produced by Beautiful Food. So also our chin chin. When you eat the chin chin, anytime you eat at Tabitha's chin chin, the taste, texture, color, everything is always the same, because we have come up with a standard and the staff have been trained to follow that standard. So when you give quality food, you would have customers coming back to you, you'll have repeat sales, and from repeat sales and referrals, because they will tell other people about you, a lot of the time people will pick a chin chin up and say to us, oh, I just had a naming party and somebody brought your chin chin as a gift. I've taken the number from the hotel. I really like this chin chin. How can I get supply? So word of mouth, referrals do come when the quality of your food is good, and with this you can grow your business. In the next episode, I will focus more on quality control and how to develop a standard and a policy for your business. Thank you very much for watching. See you again next time. Bye.